Hello everyone. So last time we saw Brownian motion, we introduced first random walk, then we went on for Brownian motion because we are going to model share prices via geometric Brownian motion, and we are going to model prices of other derivatives as functions of share prices. So we are going to have to deal with functions of geometric Brownian motion. And whenever we want to study, say, expectation or variance, something like that, for functions of geometric Brownian motion, we might need integrals with respect to Brownian motion. But as we saw in the properties, Brownian motion is continuous everywhere but differentiable nowhere. And hence, integration, like usual Riemann integration, is not possible with respect to Brownian motion, Riemann or even Riemann-Stieltjes integral, because you need differentiability there. Because you know, when you write integral x dx, you have that dx coming into picture, and here for Brownian motion, there is no way to define dz if z is the Brownian motion, because the Brownian motion is not differentiable anywhere. Hence, people have developed a different type of calculus known as Itô calculus. We are going to study Itô calculus. So, for that, we need to brush up some theoretical things that we already know. So today we'll be focusing on one such theoretical concept, that is conditional expectation. We are going to need something else called as martingale, and for defining martingale, we need to know about conditional expectation. Okay, so before going to conditional expectation, let me revise what is your definition of random variable. So when you define random variable, you bring into picture something called as a sigma field. Okay, so that is what we are going to need actually. So what is a sigma field? Sigma field is basically a collection of sets, and that collection of sets must be closed with respect to complementation. Okay, what do I mean by that? If a set A is in that sigma field, then A complement must also be in that sigma field. Then second thing is, it should be closed with respect to countable unions and intersection. Of course, it would automatically be closed with respect to finite unions and intersection. So it should be closed with respect to countable unions and intersection. If you prove for union, I mean, if it is closed for union, you can automatically prove it is closed for intersections also. So writing either one of them is sufficient. So sigma field is some collection of sets, okay, where these properties are satisfied. That is, that collection of sets should be closed with respect to complementation, and it should be closed with respect to countable unions. Okay, and then we also define concept of measurability with respect to a certain sigma field for a random variable. So we are going to need that also. So what is measurability? If you have, say, a random variable x which is supposedly defined from omega script AP to R script B. I need not bring P in picture right now. Let it be only the set and the sigma field. Okay, so x is some function defined from omega script A to R script B, where A and B both are sigma fields. Then we say that x is a random variable with respect to them. So that is, x is measurable with respect to this omega script A if for every B which is from script B, that is for every Borel set, x inverse of that B should be in script A. That is your definition of measurability. So we say that x is measurable with respect to omega script A if inverse image under X of every Borel set is in script A. Okay, so we are going to need these two concepts, measurability and sigma field, for defining conditional expectation. I know all of you have learnt conditional expectation before, but we have learnt mostly in the usual distribution theory kind of way. So you define, say, conditional expectation of X given Y. Let us assume x, y both are continuous. Then you define it as integration of x with respect to conditional PDF of x, correct? Okay. this is for some fixed value of y, right? And this conditional PDF you get as joint PDF of xy divided by marginal PDF of the conditioning variable, correct? Ideally, I should write fxy here, fyy here, fx given y here, and so on. Okay, so now we are going to define a more theoretical version of conditional expectation. So let me state the definition first and then we will discuss it. Okay, so one more concept that we are going to need is a sub sigma field. Okay, so you know sigma field, similarly we are going to need a sub sigma field. So what is a sub sigma field? So if I have two sigma fields, let's say script A and say script D, and if script A is subset of script D, so basically this is sigma field also, and script A is subset of script D, then you say that script A is a sub sigma field. So it has to be subset of that sigma field, and it has to be a sigma field in itself, that is also necessary. Okay, then we say that script A is a sub sigma field. Okay, so let me now state the definition of conditional expectation. As I said, I'll first state and then we will discuss the implications of that. Now let omega script f p be a probability space. So when I say probability space, omega is some set, script f is a sigma field of subsets of omega. It need not contain all subsets of omega, just that every set from script f is a subset of omega. That is the only condition. And of course script f is a sigma field. So let omega script f p be a probability space. Let script d be a sub sigma field of script f. Okay, script d be a sub sigma field of script f. Further, let x be a random variable defined on this original space, that is omega script f p, with finite expectation. So with expectation of mod x finite. Okay, then so these things are defined, then the conditional expectation of x, conditional expectation of x given the sigma field, sub sigma field D, so given script D denoted by expectation of x given D, okay, this is a random variable. This conditional expectation is a random variable satisfying following two conditions. So what are those conditions? First condition is expectation of x given d is demeasurable. Okay, this is one condition. And secondly, for every set A in script D, integral of expected x given d dp over A is same as integral x dp over A. Okay, let us try to discuss what are we saying here. So I have a probability space and I have some random variable defined on that probability space. So when I say I have a random variable defined on this probability space, it means that this random variable is measurable with respect to this f. Okay, now script D is a sub sigma field of f. Okay, and the random variable has a finite expectation. Now we are defining conditional expectation of x given d. So I think here itself things start becoming different. So far you must have always defined conditional expectation of a random variable given some other random variable. Okay. Whereas now we are defining conditional expectation given a sigma field. I want you to think about how you defined independence in probability theory. So this is exactly same problem. So when you defined independence in BSc, you said that two random variables were independent, say x and y, then product like for example PDF, joint PDF of xy would be product of marginal PDFs, right? And you also defined two sets or two events to be independent. So you said two events A and B are independent, then probability of A intersection B would be probability of A into probability of B. Whereas when you studied probability theory, you first studied independence of two sigma fields. Okay, from independence of sets or events, you went to independence of two sigma fields, and then you defined two random variables to be independent if the corresponding sigma fields were independent, right? Sigma fields generated by those random variables, if they were independent, then you concluded that the two random variables were also independent. So what we know is a random variable is basically equivalent in properties to whatever we can say about the sigma field generated by that random variable. Okay, hence here also we are defining conditional expectation in terms of sigma field. Okay, and of course we would come to the definition of conditional expectation in terms of given a random variable, but initial definition is this. Okay, now something else that you might find odd is I'm saying this is a random variable. So I'm saying expectation of x given d itself is again a random variable. So remember, you might feel that okay, it's an expectation, so it's a constant, but no, it's a conditional expectation, so it is going to be a function of the conditioning thing. So even when you were in BSc, if you say computed expectation of x given y equal to say certain y, then it could turn out to be a function of y. Okay, by function I mean not PDF, so some function of y. Okay, so conditional expectation itself is a random variable because it can be function of the conditioning thing. I know, I'm sure some of you are still finding it very hard to digest, but then I have an exercise for you. Go home, check your BSc notes, you know, for some conditional distributions and try to find conditional expectation and convince yourself that it can be a function of the, I'm saying it can be, it doesn't have to be, but yes, it can be a function of the given part, okay, the conditioning part. So this is a random variable and it satisfies two properties. So the first property is, because it's a random variable, it will be measurable with respect to some sigma field, right? So we are saying it is script D measurable. Okay. So because it's a random variable, it must be measurable with respect to some sigma field. So we are saying that it is demeasurable. Okay, so expectation of x given d is demeasurable, and this is an additional property. We won't go into the theory of this property, but you should remember this, that for every set from script D, integral of the expectation as well as integral of the original random variable is exactly the same. So the integrals are same doesn't necessarily mean that the two integrands are same. Okay, we will study a bit later in what case can we conclude that the two integrands are same from the integrals being same. Okay, so a couple of things you should remember. We are saying conditional expectation is certain function satisfying certain properties. So we are not defining expectation in the way that we did earlier. So we are not giving a direct formula for conditional expectation. Okay, it's any function which fulfills these properties. Okay, of course conditional expectation does have many nice properties that usual expectation has. For example, it is linear. So let me quickly summarize the properties which are very easy to which are very obvious. We will study the other properties a bit later. So one property, as I said, is linearity. So what do I mean by linearity? So expectation of x plus y given some sigma field d would be same as expectation of x given d plus expectation of y given d. So this is a property which is exactly similar to your usual expectation. Then you do have monotonicity. What do I mean by monotonicity? If x is less than or equal to y almost surely, then conditional expectation of x given d would be less than or equal to conditional expectation of y given d. Now I have to write almost surely. In usual expectations, you don't need almost surely because they become constant. But here, they are random. So I'm writing almost surely here. So you have monotonicity. Then you have your usual, Markov inequality that you studied in probability theory. And then you have Jensen's inequality. Okay. So Jensen's inequality. And you had dominated convergence theorem. So all these things that you studied for usual expectation, they do hold for conditional expectation also, but we are not going to go into their proofs because we are not really interested in those proofs right now. We are interested in some other properties of conditional expectation. So we would study not just dominated convergence theorem, your Fatou's lemma and monotone convergence theorem, all those things hold for conditional expectation also. But as I said, we won't go into their proofs because we are not much interested in them. We want to use those properties of conditional expectation which would be helpful for us in defining martingale, in studying martingale, and thereby developing the theory for Itô calculus. Okay. So today we have just introduced the definition of conditional expectation and we have seen which properties it shares with the usual expectation that we have. In the next lecture, we will study few more properties of conditional expectation which are slightly different from the usual expectation. Okay, let me stop here. Thank you.